Not live yet. Hello! Welcome. I've got, before anyone says about the cheesy music, it's free, copyright free, so.
What cheesy? There's no cheese on it.
That's such a bad joke. It's just honestly terrible. I can't believe that just came out of your mouth. So in case you're wondering what I'm partaking in, this is a pint of gin and cloudy lemonade.
Oh yeah, I used to drink that. One time we got invited to a friend's.
Yeah, here we go, yeah.
I had a thing about, it's not gin, I did not drink gin at that time. I always had vodka and bitter lemon, and we went to their house and my dad, oh come on, choo, what do you want to drink? I said, all right then, vodka and bitter lemon, and he said, okay. He disappeared for about 15 minutes.
We went to the shop together. That's commitment to your guests.
Yeah.
Did he?
Yeah.
Anyway, hi guys. I just saw someone mention, the t-shirts are merch available from the store. I'm sporting the rather fetching XL size. Mum's got the small on, obviously.
Yeah, small. Yeah.
Cookbook is also available on there, which we're now in third print of. Today, what are we doing, Mum?
Duck Chow Mein.
It is Duck Chow Mein. And we're actually going to do it how we would do this in our takeaway. And we always give you the standard recipes, and then later on we'll start doing the better recipes and stuff. But we wanted to give you a baseline first of just the standard ones that you would get anywhere else in the country. So if you like that kind of thing and you're new to this channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And what else should they do, Mum?
What?
That's fine. Don't listen to me at all.
What do you say?
I can't remember now.
Oh, never mind. It's all right. It'll come back to me.
Duck chow mein. So first of all, that's a great question, Terry. Word chow mein literally means fried noodles.
Yeah, chow mein.
So it can be anything.
Yeah.
This is what really annoys me about the pretension in Chinese cooking as well. You can literally just have noodles with nothing in it. As long as it's fried in a pan, it's chow mein.
Yeah.
We're going to put two
blocks in it.
Two blocks in. Just, we always cook two blocks because two blocks actually cook better than
because
one.
Yeah, one is a bit lonely, isn't it? So we bet two is always two make a couple. You need two to make a couple, isn't it?
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Yeah, two make
so one is lonely, two is awesome.
We're not actually timing this, we just literally go by eye, but usually it takes about 6 to 7 minutes.
Yeah.
And turn the temperature down a bit.
Let it boil.
Do you want to cut up the onion or should we wait? Because that can make us cry. We've got sensitive eyes.
I don't know.
Goldfish paste will be available when, soon, hopefully.
How do you know the noodle is cooked? Oh.
By doing this for about 34 years.
And there was another thing.
It's quite close.
Yeah, you can see it. You know, like that. Don't do it, okay? Like this, we click it.
You can do it like this, but don't.
There's a white bit in it. You can see it like that, yeah? I don't know how close the camera can see it. And when it's that one is all gone, that means it will be ready.
So, what I'm doing is I am rinsing the noodles. This is really important. It stops them cooking. And it washes out all the starch so they don't go sticky. What you don't want to do is, like I did, and mix the colander and let it go all over your feet, because that's not optimal.
Hi, cooking with Chef Guy.
Hey, guys in.
Yes, it's amazing. Yes, we're live again. Yeah, we are live.
Anyway, we're going to leave them to drain on the side. So now we've done the noodles, we're going to let them sit for as long as we can. We want to get as much moisture out of those as you can.
Do you call it sit or stand?
We sell them on our web store. We sell, in fact, we're the cheapest web store for Chinese supermarket stuff on the internet at the moment in the UK.
This one.
Chinandchoo.com. We use Lucky Boat number ones for these ones.
This one.
Again, on our website, all available. So I'm about to reveal the duck, well, not the kind of duck that Chinese takeaways will use, okay? Are you ready? On the count of three, Mum, ready?
One,
two, three! It's slightly overwhelming, I know, but it's literally, you go into a Chinese supermarket, in their frozen section, they will have duck, and it will say roasted boneless duck. This is what they use. This is a brand that's actually quite good. It's called Big Eight. It's fairly cheap and really nice for what you're paying for. The best brand that we use is called Cherry Valley. That's actually quite expensive. Oh, thank you very much. I can't take a shot on it.
What?
Stardust says, on my other channel,
Stardust.
tin vlog. Every time someone donates a fiver, I do a shot of whiskey. But it's
take a shot, yeah.
Very different channel. No. You don't need to do a shot.
Oh, all right.
I mean, you can if you want.
Yeah, all right. I take a shot. Mango, sparkling. Oh, okay. Yeah, hi. I really like this. I haven't done this for ages. When was the live one you did?
Last live stream was when
we were... 2 years ago, was it?
No.
A year and a half. You do the one that...
It's when we had...
With the prawns, wasn't it? The fried rice.
Yeah, let me talk.
Yeah.
It's when we had 20,000 subscribers. Was nearly about a year ago, yeah. The duck actually comes as a whole duck, and you've got to take it apart. It's frozen, by the way, so you've got to defrost it. But most takeaways give you about less than... So they'll get probably 6 portions out of this, won't they?
More than 6.
And in ours, we'll only get 4.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So what we'll do...
Minimum 6 for them, yeah.
We're going to take half...
half of the breast.
Half of the breast, and we'll cut it upside down, just sort of peel off the... you pass the pan? Yeah. We'll take half of the breast and half of the leg. Skin down, okay?
I like the leg. I do not like the breast.
Yeah, me too. I like the leg.
I like the leg. Leg is good. Da-da-da! Leg is good. You see, I'm still able to kick. I'm in 60 now.
Well, wow! Didn't realise when you get to 60, you lose the ability to kick.
What degree?
Should we meet side down first, actually?
Meet side down, yeah?
Yeah.
Right.
The way to do this so it comes out really nice is as low as possible, deal with quite a firm heat.
Yeah.
That sounds odd to say, but you really want this duck to render on the outside without burning.
Yeah.
And the only way to do that is like cooking crispy bacon, you do it on a fairly low heat. Not too low, otherwise it will take years.
Still retain its moisture. You know, if you put it on high heat, you just get it burned, and you just the juice just evaporates down in a high heat.
Yeah. Vegetable oil, always vegetable oil. What a takeaway will always use vegetable oil. They won't use nuts because it's expensive, and when people expect to only pay between £5 and £6 for a chow mein, can't afford to use nut oil.
Yeah, brown nuts oil is nice, but it's too expensive to use. But it's always vegetable oil, but not olive oil. Olive oil doesn't go with Oriental cooking. It goes with Mediterranean.
Yeah, if you're using olive oil, it's not. It gives it like a diesel-y flavour.
Yeah.
Also, it burns. Sesame oil burns as well. That's why you don't deep fry with it, because you can't.
Oh, but we are not telling you to use it. But if you want to use olive oil, It's entirely up to you. It's perfectly fine,
yeah.
Yes.
It's what you like at the end of the day. My takeaway is called Ziangs Chinese Takeaway, and Mum's is called Ziangs at the Weir, Sprat/Slash Malaysian Noodle Bar.
No, sesame oil is not alright for cooking.
Who said that?
Someone asked sesame oil alright for cooking.
No.
Not for cooking,
it's
though.
It's a garnish.
It's garnish. It's like a finished product.
If someone's put in sesame oil... you can use it in a marinade. I'll take that back. If someone's put it in a marinade and they're cooking,
that's
fine.
Right.
If they're using it as the sort of...
Substitute for oil, but not very good.
No, they honestly don't know what they're talking about. Having said that, though, if you like that flavour, you like the flavour, because I like weird things. I like taking McDonald's chips and dunking them in strawberry shake. So
there's no right way or wrong way to do it, but I'm just saying that how you want to do it this way...
Well, it's just a Chinese takeaway window.
Enhanced, yeah. Enhanced a flavour.
Perfect. Some colour on the bottom. That's all we wanted, some colour. That also, why you put the meat down side first, meat side down first, is because it allows the meat to warm up and become a little bit flexible so that you can get more contact with the skin on the pan. That's all that's for, really. So now we've skin side. We want to turn the temperature up just a second.
What? Bloody hell, stop spitting, you duck.
That wasn't weird. Up a little bit. So it's 1,000 watts or so. So we want to get some colour on the skin. That's basically what we're trying to do with this duck. So I'll move this around the pan.
Please like if you're enjoying it. Or tin bean sprout. You know, honestly, I have not used
tin bean sprout. I've never tried tin bean sprout.
I will try that now you mention it. Yeah. I guess it's like a bean sprout being poached in hot water. You can then put in the tin. It probably, I will get one next time when I'm in the supermarket. Then I'll let you know then, all right? What your thoughts? Well done, you guys.
No, we're not Koreans, we're Chinese, Malays. Malay Chinese, sorry. No, Chef Dai doesn't look Korean.
No, no, I haven't seen him. How old are you, Chef Dai?
38.
Are you that young?
Because you talk old. And people wonder, the way you do this for our Duck Chow Mein, people wonder why it costs so much more than a normal one. Because a normal place will literally just chop this up and throw it in the pan and it will smell fishy.
Yeah, they're not even let the heat seal the meat. I don't mind. I honestly don't get that.
That's done.
Hey, what's that? Is that a thumbs up or a middle finger?
That's to me, Mum.
Oh, all right.
No, it's to you. Be offended.
Yeah,
no, it's not.
Yeah, I know. I can take a joke.
But it's not. It's for me. So I'm going to cut this duck up. Some places will do it like really nicely, but some places will take the time and carve through the skin to make sure it sticks together. But we literally just whack it in. Yes. It's going to go into the.
If it's restaurant, yeah, but if it's takeaway, you're going to put in a container and take it home and all that. Onion now, yeah?
Yes, I forgot we're going to have to cut the onions. Slices.
Is that half
an
onion? Half, yeah?
Yeah, half. So Mum's going to cut up the onion. I'm going to put about a dessert spoon and a half of oil into the pan.
I like this cook and talk. Do you want it this way or that way?
Whichever way you want.
All right.
That way, yeah.
This way?
No.
That way?
Yeah.
I'm not going short off, all right? This is how we normally at home will cut. Okay?
No, it's not. Oh. Why did you just lie, Tara? Right, so, we never cut that slowly. Yeah, strong. So we're going to get them in the pan to get that, letting the oil heat up in the pan.
Onion, yeah?
Yeah.
All of it?
Yeah, might as well. Why not, eh? Do you want me to do this? Yeah, I'll do this. Yeah, you can talk to the people.
Yeah, onion is in the wok, okay?
I'm going to get some colour on them.
Yeah, get a colour, get them dancing.
Get them dancing?
Yeah.
Do you like dancing, Mum?
Sort of.
You don't like it?
Yeah, I do. I do like dancing, but I can't dance. I cannot dance. It's not that I can dance. Right. I cannot dance.
I'm putting a third teaspoon of salt in and a third teaspoon of MSG. It goes in the pan. This is really to brown it off and get a nice colour on the onions. We're going to use a handful of the... Now I'm going to let that sit. If you've got a halogen hob, it's going to take longer for you to get the char flavour, but you can still get it. If someone tells you you need gas, you need high heat, that's a poor workman blaming his tools. You can get the same char, you just got to be very patient.
Yeah, and what's all you can do your nail,
yeah,
or flat your eyebrows.
Yeah, exactly.
Or do your makeup, or put on your lipstick.
Because if you look at our reviews about our food, they're like 5-star. We don't have gas. We use this exact wok in our kitchens. So when people tell you that you need it turbo hot, that's someone who doesn't know how to cook properly. You can buy MSG on our website.
Yeah.
See, you get a nice little char there. And again, let it sit.
Yeah, let it sit. Do not disturb it there.
Gonna turn it over again. Right, now I'm gonna add a little bit more MSG. Literally, probably about a quarter teaspoon. I'd say a fifth teaspoon of salt again, but not much, literally less than that. Pretty much a pinch. This is where I'm going to add some sugar. And I mean a pinch of sugar. Literally a tiny amount. And it goes. I'm trying to put that back in the bean sprout, idiot. And no, someone I just saw a comment earlier. Someone said, do you not need a really hot wok? Yes, to start with. But when you start putting ingredients in there, it's going to cool down. It's like, unless you've got a 45 kilowatt wok burner at home, you're never going to get the mega power. But it's knowing how to do it properly. That means that you can start doing it properly at home. It's really not difficult. People wanting to think it's harder than it is so they can impress their friends. Perfect. Right, catching really nicely now. These people are not it. Say I'm Chinese in Chinese. No, let's say it in Mandarin.
What's the Chinese?
Now say it in Hakka.
My hair is Hakka.
Now say it in Cantonese.
Why, Zhongguoyan?
That's three dialects of Chinese mum just spat out in front of you. Plus you can speak fluent Malaysian.
Yeah.
Someone's mad that I'm telling the truth because look, charring, it's on camera. This is awkward for you.
Who was it? Grow up,
Nick. Oh, brilliant. Anyway, So we're going to do the final stages of this. I'm going to put...
Someone say we are cautious.
Two teaspoons of, or 2.5 teaspoons of light soy. Said we're not Chinese. We look Chinese, but we're not. And two teaspoons of dark.
Get a line. Please, can you tell me how
does
a Chinese look, please?
Well, I just ignore him. He's already been made to look stupid.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah,
okay. It's swimming now, that noodle, swimming like snake.
I'm going to put a little bit more dark in because I like my noodles darker. Yeah. Oh, cool. Oh. Okay, so now we're going to put in the duck.
Ooh, duck, I love it.
So we're just warming the duck up now, trying to get a bit more flavour on it.
Looking forward, now I've got my chilli ready.
Any bowl here. A bit. Right, so now we're going to add a handful of bean sprouts. And you don't want to cook these for that long.
You like it crispy.
You add your bean sprouts at the end because they stay white.
Yeah.
Now, it's at this point that some people like to add sesame oil, which is fine. But now you can, because there's enough in here to not let that sesame oil burn, because we're very nearly finished. I don't like to cook with it at all. To me, it's a garnish, and I wouldn't put it on a chow mein because it's just not cricket, if I'm honest. It's a little bit like having a full English and then going and getting for chippy curry sauce and pouring it over the top. It's going to taste good, but it's just not right, you know? Okay, and that's it. That's that done. Finish it off with a tiny drizzle of dark soy, just because it can never happen.
It's not nice, yeah.
And chilies. I'm going to do that influencer thing of taking photos of it. Sorry, guys.
This is a hot chili. I can smell it now. Oh, my goodness.
Lee Kumki every time. Pearl River's more traditional. If you want to make traditional Chinese food, Pearl River. If you want to make Western Chinese takeaway taste good, Lee Kumki every time. Mm-hmm. Weird that there's char there.
I like full English as well.
Kokomo sauce is really nice for dipping. I wouldn't cook with it, but it looks a really nice condiment. So that's duck chow mein.
Look at this noodle, how amazing.
Yeah. Sorry, Alex, some wanker said we weren't Chinese. We didn't know how to cook. So they couldn't get char on a induction cooker. But there's char here because you can see it on the onions and you can see it on the noodles. And then got really angry when I said that a poor workman blames his tools. We started the channel how... anyone really does. It's just all cramp in my foot. That's where it's gone. Literally just one day I sat down and said the world needed to see my mum because she's awesome. People forget that this is my channel and I know mum is the star because that's how I designed it because I knew she always would be. If I did it by myself, I wouldn't get anywhere near as many subscribers. No, mum, it's fine. I understand that. I do understand that, and that's why I did it. The world needed to see mum. That's all it was. Sorry, we normally talk about how the flavour of this, but it's just too good. We just keep eating it. If you've never had duck chow mein before, imagine when it's cooked like this. It's really silky, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's like jerry, but this is really smooth. It's duck is almost made for noodles, to be honest.
Duck made for anything.
Yeah.
Bit ginger. Ginger garlic.
No, we've heard nothing about the play button, I'm afraid.
What play button?
If you reach 100,000 subscribers, YouTube gives you a silver play button. It's not real play, it's just like a trophy to say you've reached that milestone. They don't just give you a play button so you can press it. And just,
oh, all right. Okay.
Is that what you thought?
Yeah. No. So what are they going to press the play button? What do they do? Okay, all right. See how I don't know about this. I was born a long time ago.
How do I...
Oh my god, I think I need to retire now.
Yeah,
guys.
Right, we've got to go to bed. It's getting late.
Yeah, what time is it? It's
12 now.
Bloody. Good night, all. Thank you so much. It's amazing, you guys. Keep up the good work.
Yeah, thank you. Take care.
Night night.